So we learned about the chain rule, and when I derived the chain rule, we did some differentials. There's another use of differentials to derive the triple product rule. The triple product rule comes up a lot in chemistry when you discuss thermodynamic quantities. So someone like a chemical engineer would need the triple product rule. But it's also something that I find to be rather cool. So I wanted to spend a lecture or two lectures on this, actually. So in this lecture, I'll derive the triple product rule. And in the next short lecture, I'll give you an example using the ideal gas law. Okay, so what is the triple product rule? We assume we have three variables, and I'll call them X, Y, and Z, but they're related. Okay, so you can write then a function f of x, y, z equal to 0. So that gives you the relationship between the three variables x, y, and z. Since they're related, you ought to be able to solve for x or solve for y or solve for z. So for instance, you can write x, which is a function of y and z. Or you can write z as a function of x and y. Okay? Let's take the differential of these expressions using the partial derivatives, like I did in the lecture on the chain rule. So we have the differential dx is equal to the partial of x with respect to y times dy, plus the partial of x with respect to z times dz. Okay? And then we also have the differential of z, dz, is equal to the partial of z with respect to x dx, plus the partial of z with respect to y dy. Okay? All's good, I think. Now what I want to do is to eliminate dz from this first equation using the second equation, okay? Because I don't want dx, dy, dz. I only want to have two variables. So if we do that, we end up with dx equals partial of x with respect to y dy plus partial of x with respect to z times dz, which is partial of z with respect to x dx, plus partial of z with respect to y dy. Okay? The next obvious thing to do is to group the dx terms and the dy terms on the same side. So if we put the dx on the left side and the dy on the right, the dx will end up with a 1 here, and then minus dx dz, dz dx times dx. And then we have the dy on the right, so we have dx dy. We put the dx on the left, the dy on the right. So we have dx dy here, and then plus dx dz, dz dy, plus dx dz, dz dy, and that's multiply dy. Okay, now the key here is that we have x, y, and z variables with one relationship between them, given by this function of x, y, z equals 0. Because there's only one relationship, it means we can vary two of these variables independently. Okay? We can vary any two of these variables independently. So that means we can vary x independently, we can vary y independently. So dx and dy are independent variables that can take any values. So in order for this equality to hold, the terms in the parentheses must be 0. Okay, so let's start with the first term in parentheses. So that means dx dz dz dx is supposed to be equal to 1. Dx dz dz dx equals 1 in order for the first parentheses to be 0. This means that dz dx is the multiplicative inverse of dx dz, right? So dz dx is 1 divided by dx dz. That makes a lot of sense, right? You change the numerator, you flip the numerator and the denominator, and it's the reciprocal, okay? So that's a relationship that makes sense to us. Dx dz dz dx equals 1, okay? What about the second relationship? The second relationship says dx dy is equal to minus dx dz dz dy, okay? But let's put everything on the same side. So we have a dx dy. To put the dz dy on the left, we can use this first identity and take the reciprocal. So this one is equivalent to dx dy. We move the dz dy to the left, it becomes dy dz, so dy dz. And then we move the dx dz on the right to the left, so it becomes dz dx. And what we have left is a minus 1. That's called the triple product rule. Okay, this is the triple product rule. Okay, let's look at that carefully. Dx dy, notice the y matches. Dx dy, dy dz, notice the z matches. Dz dx, dx dy, dy dz, dz dx equals minus 1, minus 1. That always amazes me, you know? I mean, if these were normal derivatives, derivatives of a function of single variable, you would be very happy to cross out dy dy, dz dz, dx dx, and get plus 1. But partial derivatives don't work that way. Partial derivatives are not delta x divided by delta y, like a single variable derivative. They behave differently. So this triple product rule, you don't get plus 1, you get minus 1. Okay, let me review. So the triple product rule is when you have two variables that have a single relationship, and you can write that relationship, say, as f of x, y, z equals 0. We didn't actually use that formula. But what it means is that you can solve for x, so x is a function of y and z, or you can solve for z, so z is a function of x and y. When we look at these differentials, dx, dz, we can vary these things, two of the variables at least independently. The third one depends on the other two. But we can look at dx and dz, and we can use dz to eliminate dz in the dx equation. So we end up with an equation that just has dx and dy. Since x and y can be varied independently, these terms in the parentheses must be identically zero. The first one gives us the reciprocity relationship. So I don't think I can spell this, but reciprocity relation, which is that dx dz is equal to 1 over dz dx, which makes a lot of sense, easy to remember. And then using that relation, we can work the second parentheses, and then we get the triple product rule. Dx dy, dy dz, dz dx equals not plus 1, but minus 1. Doesn't make any sense, but it's correct. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching. In the next video, I'll work an example from a real chemistry or physics called the ideal gas law. See you in the next video.